The U.S. economy has been on recession watch for months now. And so far, the all-important American consumer has been holding strong, keeping those recession forecasts from becoming true.
Consumer is still spending.
Consumer is in better shape. If they have money, they're going to spend it.
Our consumer is continuing to be resilient.
The consumer health has been resilient so far this year.
New data shows Americans are digging themselves deeper into credit card debt, which is now hitting an all-time high.
For the first time ever, the total credit card debt across the U.S. has topped $1 trillion. That's a $154 billion spike from this time last year.
Hold on to your wallets because the credit card crisis is reaching heights and delinquencies are rising, painting a terrifying picture of a credit bubble on the edge of disaster. This credit card crisis poses a serious threat to the financial stability and well-being of millions of Americans, especially those who are young, low-income, or living in financially distressed areas. Join me as we unravel the chaos, dissect the numbers, and explore how this credit storm could be the next financial collapse. The current state of credit card debt in the United States is raising alarms, echoing the warning signs observed in the lead-up to the 2008 financial crisis. According to a Federal Reserve survey, credit card delinquencies have surged to 2008 levels, reaching a concerning milestone. The total credit card debt in the country has surpassed $1 trillion for the first time in history. This escalating trend is underscored by the fact that new credit card delinquency rates have exceeded their pre-pandemic levels. The comparison to the assurances of a soft landing from prominent figures like Janet Yellen in 2007 and Jerome Powell in recent times adds a layer of skepticism to the current economic landscape. What's particularly alarming is the revelation that one in five Americans is financing groceries through buy now, pay later schemes. This shift towards using installment loans for everyday expenses, including groceries, raises questions about the overall health of the economy. Financing basic necessities like bread, milk, and eggs through installment loans signals a potential economic train wreck. There are signs that a substantial wealth transfer is on the horizon. Many Americans might be compelled to sell homes, cars, and assets, while some may venture into new businesses based on emerging trends. The impending economic changes are expected to create winners and losers, depending on one's ability to navigate the shifting landscape. The data on household debt is currently at an all-time high, with credit card delinquency rates reaching levels comparable to the 2008 crisis. The situation is further worsened by other indicators, such as auto loan defaults. While homes presently hold significant equity, a potential economic downturn could challenge homeowners' ability to retain their properties. The looming affordability crisis in the housing market is explored, highlighting the possibility of a surge in home sales coupled with a diminished pool of prospective buyers. This could lead to increased control by buyers in a market where affordability becomes a critical concern. The statistics on credit card delinquencies are staggering. Balances have soared to $1 trillion, while the share of credit card debt falling behind has climbed to 8% in the year's third quarter. This is a notable increase from 6.5% in the first quarter of 2023, marking a decade-high 30-day credit card delinquency rate. The subprime segment is particularly vulnerable, with credit card delinquencies projected to reach 9.1% by the end of the year. This places credit cards in a territory traditionally associated with riskier financial products like payday loans. The analysis suggests that credit card delinquencies are likely to continue rising, especially considering the economic uncertainties, the holiday season, and the potential challenges in the job market. Concerns about the refinancing of corporate debt and the overall impact of rising interest rates further contribute to the apprehension surrounding the situation. The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, CFPB, is also gearing up to pursue credit card companies based on their late fees. This move, aimed at curbing late fees, prompts speculation about its potential impact on consumer behavior and the lending practices of credit card companies. But how did we get here? The credit card crisis is a result of a combination of several factors, including job loss and income shock. The COVID-19 pandemic caused widespread unemployment and reduced income for many Americans, especially in the service and hospitality sectors. Although the unemployment rate has declined from its peak of 14.8% in April 2020 to 4.2% in November 2021, many people are still struggling to find stable and well-paying jobs. As a result, some borrowers may have difficulty making payments on their credit card debt, or may prioritize other expenses, such as rent, utilities, or food. During the pandemic, many banks tightened their lending standards and reduced their credit limits for existing and new customers in response to the increased risk of default. This made it harder for borrowers to access new credit or roll over their existing debt. Moreover, some promotional offers, such as 0% APR balance transfers, were removed or reduced, eliminating a common strategy for borrowers to manage their debt. Another factor was the expiration of relief measures. The federal government provided unprecedented fiscal support to households during the pandemic, such as stimulus checks, expanded unemployment benefits, and eviction moratoriums. These measures helped many borrowers to stay current on their credit card payments or pay down their balances. However, most of these relief measures have expired or phased out by the end of 2021, leaving many borrowers without adequate income or savings to cope with their debt obligations. As the economy reopened and the vaccination rate increased, consumer spending rebounded strongly, especially on discretionary items such as travel, entertainment, and dining out. According to the Bureau of Economic Analysis, personal consumption expenditures rose by 12.4% in 2021, compared to a decline of 3.9% in 2020. Some of this spending was financed by credit cards, as consumers took advantage of the low interest rates and the pent-up demand. However, this also increased the credit card balances and the risk of delinquency for some borrowers. A staggering 70 million credit card accounts have been opened in the United States since pre-pandemic 2019. The widespread use of plastic for transactions underscores why credit card debt has become the most prevalent form of household debt for Americans, with an average owed amount of $6,000. A 2023 Bankrate report shows a concerning statistic: 47% of credit card holders find it challenging to settle their monthly balances. Instead, they roll over credit card balances, accumulating substantial interest and fees on unpaid amounts. This practice has become a colossal mistake, especially considering the exorbitant interest rates that credit cards carry. Some retail credit cards command interest rates of up to 33%, turning a seemingly manageable $15,000 balance into a financial problem. For instance, paying $450 a month on such a balance would result in a staggering $26,000 in interest over 7 years and 8 months. This paints a grim picture of the dire consequences of not addressing credit card debt promptly. The average interest rate currently stands at 24.25%, translating to around $20,000 in interest over 8 years and 5 months for a $15,000 balance with a monthly payment of $350. The gravity of the situation is further underscored by the fact that many Americans ignore the monthly payments, opting to make minimum payments and pushing the issue into the future. The erosion of the middle class has been a concerning trend over the last 3 years, with the wealthy getting richer while others face increasing financial challenges. To navigate this crisis strategically, individuals should consider adopting the mindset of the wealthy, building relationships with different banks and credit card companies, applying for cards judiciously, and making well-informed financial decisions are essential. Furthermore, individuals should explore options like balance transfer credit cards to alleviate the burden of high-interest consumer credit card debt. This involves transferring balances to a 0% APR card, allowing for more aggressive repayment without incurring additional interest. Playing defense is crucial in the current economic climate, as some lenders are tightening their lending criteria and slashing credit limits. Building stable income, maintaining cash reserves, and eliminating unnecessary expenses are prudent measures to fortify financial positions. The parallels with the 2008 crisis are evident, where people were forced into fire sales due to financial constraints. Those with access to funding, established relationships, and available cash found themselves in a position to acquire assets and thrive during the recovery. The impending changes in the job market and the economy suggest a significant wealth transfer. Being proactive and financially savvy in this environment can position individuals to capitalize on opportunities and weather the storm. The credit card crisis is a serious and complex problem that requires a comprehensive and coordinated approach from various stakeholders. For instance, lenders should adopt fair and prudent practices to lend and collect credit card debt, such as assessing the creditworthiness and affordability of the borrowers and offering them appropriate credit products and terms based on their income, expenses, and credit history. Another helpful way is by providing clear and transparent information and disclosures about the credit card features, fees, and charges, ensuring that the borrowers understand and consent to them, and offering flexible and supportive options and programs for borrowers who are facing financial difficulties or hardship, such as payment deferrals, forbearance, or restructuring. Also, regulators should enforce and enhance the rules and standards to protect and empower credit card users and the credit market. They can achieve this by implementing and updating the Consumer Financial Protection Act, the Credit Card Accountability, Responsibility, and Disclosure Act, and other relevant laws and regulations to ensure fair and transparent practices by credit card issuers and collectors. They should also monitor and supervise the credit card market and the credit reporting agencies to prevent and address any misconduct, fraud, or systemic risk, providing education and guidance to the credit card users to help them understand and use credit cards wisely and responsibly, and to resolve any disputes or complaints with their creditors. To achieve any meaningful headway, policymakers must play their part. They should design and implement effective and sustainable policies to support and stimulate the economy and credit card users. This includes providing fiscal stimulus and social safety nets to households and businesses to help them cope with the income shock and the debt burden caused by the pandemic and the recession, maintaining accommodative monetary policy and low interest rates to facilitate the credit availability and affordability for the borrowers and the lenders, and promoting financial inclusion and innovation, to expanding the access and choice of credit products and services for the underserved and unbanked segments of the population. The credit card crisis is a serious and complex problem that affects millions of Americans and the economy. It has significant negative impacts on financial distress and hardship, inequality and vulnerability, and macroeconomic instability and slowdown. It has some similarities and differences with the previous crisis of 2008, which was more severe and prolonged, but also involved a larger amount and share of credit card debt. The credit card crisis requires a comprehensive and coordinated approach from various stakeholders who should take proactive and responsible steps to manage and resolve the problem.